In this video, we're going to look at some general methods for solving some unknown equations. So if you have some kind of summation or some kind of anything, and you're looking to try to find a closed form for it. So I was inspired by this book, Concrete Mathematics, best book ever if you just want to sit under a tree and read a math book all day, Graham Patashnik and Knuth. This is actually section 2.5, so I didn't make up all this, but this is just me going through that material because it's kind of an intense book, and so it helps me to rethink it through. So the idea is that I want to take this summation, I want to put it in closed form. And one of the first things you always want to do is whenever you get something new and you're trying to figure it out, you kind of got to, befriend it. You got to take it out to dinner and you got to talk to it really nice if you want to kind of figure out its secrets. And so one of the first things I like to do is I'll rewrite these. I don't like these summations when they're written like this. That's very mathy. And although I love math, I also like programming. And to me, I would much rather think of a summation as being like a for loop. So k going from 0 to some n and then k squared. So to me, that makes a little bit more sense to see it that way. Another thing you probably want to do is make like a table where you kind of go through some of the basic, what does this look like? So, if n is, say, 0, I don't know why I'm doing it vertically or horizontally instead of vertically, but I guess that's what's happening. So if n is 0, then n squared is going to be 0, and then this box sub n is going to be basically that, because your terms are going to start at 0, 1 squared, 2 squared, etc., all the way up to n squared. So if you're starting at 0, then it's just going to be that first term. If n equals 1, then n squared is going to be again 1, and you're just summing these two terms, so you get 1. If n is 2, then you've got the n squared is 4, so it's really 4 plus 1 is 5. So it's going to be this plus this is this, this plus this is this, and that kind of thing. So I'm just going to fill out a couple more. 3, 4, 5, and 6, so 9. So 9 and 5 is 14. 16 and 14 is 30. 30 and 25 is 55. 55 and 36 is 91. Okay, so generally, we kind of have an idea of how it works, because if you can't even write out a simple example for it, you're never going to know if it's even functional. So the book is going to talk a little bit about the different methods for solving this, and actually I love their first method. They call it method zero. That looks funny. They call it method zero, which is look it up. Yay, and it makes me happy. This is actually a pretty famous little summation. And if you look it up, you get that n times n plus 1 times 2n plus 1 over 6 is the answer. And not over 2. I actually recorded like a fifth of this video with the wrong number in the denominator, so I'm redoing it. Okay, so it's this times this over 6. So you look it up and you're like, yay, I have the answer. All right. So that's kind of a throwaway method, but it's there, so we'll mention it. The next method would be to guess and check, or guess and prove. And by prove, we usually mean prove by induction. And so the idea would be, I just kind of stare at this for a while and I'm like, I kind of recognize this series. I'll bet you that it's this. And you're like, I'm never going to do that. No, I probably wouldn't either. But we have had other examples in other videos where we had like the Towers of Hanoi, where we had like a sequence that was like zero. I can't think of what it was now. I guess it was three. Wait, I should be able to look at this and figure this out. 3, 8, 15, 24. And we're like, oh, this is like 2 squared minus 1, and this is like 2, except it wasn't 8, it was 7. 2 cubed minus 1 and 2 to the fourth minus 1. So we thought, oh, the answer must be 2 to the n minus 1. That kind of thing. So if you are lucky, you can kind of guess and then you can prove it. So let's pretend that we guessed and we said, oh, we got it. So now the only other step is to prove it by induction. So I'll go ahead and I'll show you that. So we have guessed. I wonder what it is. I wonder if it's n times n plus 1 times 2n plus 1 over 6. I have no idea. Okay, so anyway, we'll pretend we guessed. So in order to use proof by induction, we want to use, a base case. So the first step in proofs by induction is to prove it works for a base case. So we'll call this like I is equal to 0. And I'm using a lot of times when I do proof by induction, I use a k, but since we already have a k in our problem, I don't want to get confused. So I'll say, let's prove that it works for I equals zero. So we'd be like, okay, is it true that if I have a summation of k going from zero to zero of k squared, is that equal to, and so again, the n, that's going to be where the n is. So everywhere we see is an n, we put a zero. So zero times zero plus one times two times zero plus one over six. Is that zero? And we're like, oh, okay, well on the left it's zero, and on the right it's one, da-da-da-da-da-da, over six. And yes, zero is equal to zero. Yay, it works. Okay. So the first thing we do is we prove it for a base case. And then what we're going to do is we're going to assume it works for some I. So that would mean that we're going to assume that if we go from k equals zero to I for k squared, so we're going to assume that that's going to be I times I plus one times two I plus one over six. And then our goal is to show it works for I plus one. So our goal would be to show that k equals zero to I plus one, and everywhere I see an I, I'm going to put an I plus one. So I plus one times I plus one plus one, and then two I plus one over six. So again, the idea behind proof by induction is if I assume that it works for an I and can use that assumption to prove that it also works for I plus one, then it's like, okay, so if I assume it works for zero, it has to work for one. If I assume it works for one, it has to work for two. And if it works for two, it has to work for three, and so on and so forth. So that's kind of the deal with proof by induction. Okay, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna start off with our goal. Ah, there we go. All right, so our goal again is that it's going to go from k equals 0 to I plus 1 of k squared. Now, we have an assumption that we would like to use. So this up here is our assumption. So we'd like to get this term here somewhere. So let's do that. So we're going to take the top term off. So we're actually going from k equals 0 to I. And then we're just going to list the last term by itself. All right, so we just take the top term off, and we're done. Now we have that assumption for that first term. So not plus, this is an equals. So I'm going to take this here and I'm going to plug it in for that. Okay? So I'm going to go with I times I plus 1 times 2I plus 1 over 6 plus I plus 1 quantity squared. Okay. Now my goal is to have everything over a 6. So I'm going to need to combine everything, put it all over 6, and then uncombine it. So I'm going to go ahead and kind of do a little bit of 2i squared. Now remember, I is not the square root of negative 1. It's just some random integer. I should have probably used something else. I just use I for an index because, again, thinking like a programmer. 2i squared plus 3i plus 1, I squared plus 2i plus 1. And again, we're going to put this over 6, so times 6. All right, so over here, we've got 2i to the, why did I put a, oh, I didn't put a square, 2i cubed, there we go. I thought I was wrong, but I was mistaken. Okay, bup, 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 2, oh, just regular I, 3. Ah! Okay, 2i cubed plus 3i squared plus I, and then plus 6i squared plus 12i plus 6 over 6. All right, so if I combine these, I've got 2i squared plus, I feel like I'm doing something silly. Well, first of all, I put a square there instead of a cube. 2i cubed plus 9i squared plus 13i plus 6 over 6. Now, if I'd been smart, I'm just now realizing, I'm going to have to factor out that I plus 1 eventually, so I probably, since they both had I plus 1 terms, I probably should have done that. But since we have this teachable moment, let me remind you how to do division. So I do know that in my goal is to have that I plus 1 out there by itself. So let's see if I can figure out, if I can remember how to do polynomial division. So if you had a good college algebra instructor or algebra instructor in general, you learned how to do this. But it's one of those things that a lot of times if you have someone who isn't really thinking ahead and doesn't know your personal plan for success, they might not know that you need to know how to do this. So basically the idea is I'm going to look at the leading coefficient here. So this is I. And I'm going to say, okay, so if I want to divide I into 2i cubed, I need 2i squared. And 2i squared times I is going to get me that 2i cubed. Okay. Now I'm lining it up over the I squared because it's also an I squared term, so I'm lining it up that way. So basically 2i squared times I plus 1 is going to be 2i cubed plus 2i squared. And just like with regular long division, you're going to subtract those terms off. So the goal is that this needs to be 0 every time you do this. So I've got 7i squared plus 13. And you bring down the next one. It's just, like I said, just like long division. So this I goes into 7i squared 7i times. So that's going to be 7i. So then whenever I multiply the 7i times the I plus 1, then I'll get 7i squared plus 7i. So 0. Oh, I got to subtract these off. Whew. 0. And 6i, and then bring the 6 down. And happily enough, if I do that, I get 6i plus 6, and again, subtracting them off, and I get a remainder of 0. So that means it divides evenly. So just in case you have to do something like that in the future, maybe you're like, I think somebody tried to teach me that one time, and I was like, that's stupid. I'm never going to need that. Anytime you say that in a class, you should go ahead and punch yourself in the face because eventually you are going to need it. If you're going to have any kind of an interesting life whatsoever, you should know how to do long division polynomials. All right, so I'm going to pull out that I plus 1, and now I can probably go ahead and whatever you call it thingy, factor out that other one. So it's going to be 2i probably plus 6 here and an I plus something here maybe. 1, I plus 1. That doesn't look right. You know why it doesn't look right? Because it's not right. Let's see. Oh, 3 and 3. Derp, 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 derp. All right. Because then we got the 6 and the 8. And that's 8. What's wrong with me? Oh, goodness. I can do all this math and then drop low by a simple. It is clearly too late at night to be doing these. Dropped a low by a simple factoring problem. Let's try this again. I'm going to work this out because first, outer, inner, last. Okay, finally. All right, this is too much fun. Divided by 6. All right, now again, I'm going to be reminded of my goal. Come here, girl. All right, so my goal is to show that it works. So I've got that I plus 1 like I have it. That's good. And the I plus 2 is going to become I plus 1 plus 1. And the 2i plus 3 is in, whoa, the 2i plus 3 is indeed going to become 2i plus 1 plus 1 over 6. So we can say QED, which is again Latin for mic drop. And we've completed method 1, which was guess and prove. I'm actually going to continue these methods in another video, but we've got a couple of more coming up.